Hello, I just received a memory stick replacement. After testing the RAM, the memory stick on my computer, it turns out to be damaged. This is the old one, so I ordered a new one, a replacement. Of course, it's the same speed, model, and everything, so I shouldn't have any problems installing this one. So let's take a look. Okay, safety first. Make sure that you are grounded before working on your computer, and also make sure that everything is unplugged. So now I am going to disconnect the optical drive. Also, I'm going to disconnect the hard drive. Lift this up. And these Optiplex machines are very easy to work with. So I'm going to remove the current memory sticks. And these are in good condition. And right now I'm going to install the new one. I'm going to insert it in the first slot, which is right here, the white one. You just press it down until you hear the click. Now it's secured. So what I'm going to do is I am going to run a test MEM86 to make sure that everything is working fine, that there's no issues with the new memory stick that I'm installing. Everything is secured. I'm not going to put this back in because I'm just testing the RAM. And I have to open it again, so I'm just gonna shove everything there for now and run the memory test. So I already have a USB ready for that. Plug it in. Okay, I just connected the power cord, mouse and keyboard, and the display. So let's turn it on. I'm gonna turn on the machine, and then we're gonna hit F12 on the keyboard until it takes us to the boot menu. And then from the boot menu, I'm gonna choose the SanDisk USB. I'm gonna let it do the memory test to make sure that it's in good working condition. Even though when I ran the memory test on the old one, on the defective one, it didn't report any errors, but as soon as I connected to the computer, it just rebooted and kept restarting. This is gonna take a while, so I'm gonna fast forward this, and then I'll show you the results at the end. Okay, the test passed successfully after 2 hours and 35 minutes. So now I am going to restart the computer and log into Windows and see how it goes. Okay, so now I'm Now we are in Windows. And it should be right here, install physical memory, 8 gigabytes. So it's working fine.